Please don't use bird netting in the garden. Bird netting has been known to entangle snakes like this eastern hognose snake, lizards, hummingbirds, songbirds, raccoons, and skunks. This one was relatively lucky. I found him early in the day, and he was still alive. Of course, the snake was only doing his job, patrolling the area to help keep toads and frogs from overtaking the land. Snakes tend to move along barriers they encounter, like this raised garden wall. The excess netting was loosely resting on the ground in a pile, and the snake had moved through one of the openings in the net and then got stuck. Rather than striking, hognose snakes tried to bluff by spreading out their jaws, hissing, raising up, and appearing generally menacing. And if that doesn't work, they flip over, stick out their tongue, and play dead. But fortunately, it didn't come to that with our hognose. Using small, blunt-tipped scissors, we slowly and carefully cut away the net that bound him. Because I checked the garden often and was able to find the snake quickly, this turned out to be just a minor disturbance in his day. However, many other wildlife are not so lucky, and I now know of many other animals that have become hopelessly entangled and died in the net before they could be rescued. So while netting is convenient and effective, it wasn't worth the lives of the wildlife I value. So we took it down. We decided to use a combination of brightly colored rubber snakes, noisy, moving wind chimes with the bonus of scary eyes, and a large, tough balloon with scary eyes drawn on. But birds are pretty smart. If we don't move the items around, they'll realize these deterrents don't move, unless we change them in the garden. So I plan on putting out reflective streamers, pinwheels, and other distractions throughout the season, and we look forward to many months of beautiful, healthy, homegrown produce. And as for the birds, well, we take care of them too by planting native fruit and nut-producing plants, eliminating chemical pesticides, and by providing water and shelter for them. Well, we give them a wildscape. And we hope that they don't mind allowing us to keep those tomatoes all to ourselves.